Hi there, and welcome to the second of our top of the hour tips and tricks sessions. This month, I'm going to be focusing on Q&A and Excel and a couple of tricks you may not know. But a little bit of housekeeping first. All of the examples I'm about to do are in Q&A version 11. Most of them will work with Q&A 10, but it might just pay to test them first. And yes, for all those who were disappointed, we can now have macros in Q&A 11. They're a little bit more complex, and we do need to get your IT guys to sign off on some things. So if you are interested, give me a call and we'll sort out a session to go through those. Also, there's no need to frantically scribble down notes. This session is being recorded, which you can download and watch later. And we do have all of these tricks included in a tips and tricks document that you can see on screen that we are happy to send out to you. Just give us a yell and we'll send it out. And lastly, as this is just a 10-minute session, we won't have time for an open questions session later. If you or the team are having issues with Q&A, what it's doing, what it's not doing, what you would like to know how to do, or even if it can do it, please give us a call and we can set up a targeted training upskilling session for you and the team to go over your data and your reports. Okay, here we go. We're going to start with a fairly easy one of identifiers for data scenes. Now, as we know, we do need the 1, 3, 6 on the first line. And then we can either copy that down or we just need the 6 for subsequent lines. I tend to set my journals up so that I use the 1, 3, 6 on all the lines. It doesn't really matter. It depends how your core journal is set up. But I'm even too lazy to do that. So what I do is I've got a little formula that I use for the is blank, which looks at my amount column. And if the amount column is blank, it puts nothing. But if it is, it puts the identifier. Now, all I do is I just copy and paste that all the way down for as long as I think I'm ever going to need a journal. And again, you can set the second one down so it just does the 6. You take the 1, 3 out if you want. And you'll see now that the minute I put an amount in, it adds the identifier for me. So I don't even need to do that. How easy is that? Second trick, every now and again, this is an Excel trick. Every now and again, you'll be doing some calculations in your reports and you'll come up with this div 0 thing because the function is trying to divide 0 into something. So it gives it, but it does make the report ugly. So I have a little, again, an if error function that says if that calculation does give me an error, please put a 0 in there. Or in some cases where I've got lots of lines that are going to end up with the zeros, which does kind of clutter up the report, I can even do it so that if it's an error, make it blank. So if there's going to end up with your div 0 in that cell, it just leaves it blank. And of course, you can do that for non-erroring cells as well. It's just a straight if statement. So if that's going to equal 0, I just want it to be blank. So there we go. Little trick to tidy up some of your reports. And now next, we're going to have a look at extraction types. When you're building a report, I'm starting to build a little P&L report here. Don't forget that when we're doing our setting things up, we can do things like, now for this report, this is my income figure. And it's, of course, because it's all credits, it's going to be in a negative. And as most of us know, all we need to do is to wander over into the gray area for that particular line. And click on extraction type, and I can reverse the sign. So it's going to make my report look nice. But don't forget that we also have all of these other things that we can do. If we want to do a count, if we want the count of the number of transactions, We can do averages, minimums, maximums. You can scale, so you might only want to see your reports in your millions. And there's a thing called distinct count. And this is means we can do things like, if you wanted to see how many journals were posted, we'd do a count on the journal type. But if we wanted to know how many types of journals, the distinct count would bring out just how many different types of journals were used. You can use this for operators. How many operators? Rid of my reminders. How many operators posted journals this month? Which operators posted journals this month? So there's lots of other things we can do there. And of course, there is also an options that I'm going to have a little bit look at later, that we can for changing our search criteria, but we'll get to that a bit later. So here we go. So we can change our extraction type. Now here we come along to, I finished my report and it's really good. And I've got some breakouts happening, but I want my breakouts to actually include my department names in the report. And I don't really want to have to go and overwrite them each time. So again, there is a little formula and it's in the document. If you want it, we can send out to you. And all that does is this picks up from the name that ends up on the sheet tab is the name that gets ended up putting on the report. So when I run by my department names, I expand my report out by department names, it adds that department name into the header. So that's it's just a nice little tidy up trick for adding things. Last one I really want to look at today is a few things with doing. Here we go. We're going to do a summary report. I'll click at PK1. Remembering, I'm going to type it in. I'm going to go and look at my analysis codes, in particular, my product type. I'll have a look at all of them. And I just want code and name, so I can bring that out. So I can see all of my codes. If I want to do a report on them, I can do the same thing. I can run a summary report. But in this case, I will select from my ledger. And because I know I've only got limited data in PK1, I'm going to click for all accounts and all periods. And I'm going to bring out my product analysis code, my product analysis code name, and the base amount. So because this is a summary report, this is going to give me a total for all of my product codes and the balance there. And a lot of cases here, we see I've got this code set up so we can have blank analysis codes. I'm going to cheat and copy this over. So if I want to see just my blank analysis codes, the same way we used to do this in Q&A 10, we go and find my product analysis code, and we just put an exclamation mark in there to say we want to see the blank ones. Here we go. That's easy enough. Now, the trick with Q&A 11 is with Q&A 10, if we wanted to see the blank ones and something else, we used to do something like this. We'd do the want to do a range, so we'll have our blank ones, our exclamation mark, and say HO1 and HO2. Now that would used to bring us out our unanalyzed and our two codes there. In Q&A 11, when I run this, see it's brought out my unanalyzed, but it's brought out everything else except the two I added. So it's treating it as a do not include those two. The little trick there is when I set my formula, I put the exclamation mark at the end. I blank. So now that brings me up my blanks and the two codes I requested. Just a little bit of scripting way to bring things out, but it's worthwhile knowing how to do. So that's kind of about it for today. This recording is going to end in a few seconds and revert to a live call. So if you do have any questions, please ask. As I said before, just bear in mind that we don't have time for a full open session. If you do want some more training or some more skilling or have a pile of ideas, you know where to find us. We're easy to track down. So that's about it for now. Thank you very much for watching and listening, and we'll be in touch next month. Cheers.